Let me introduce myself. My name is Michaela Barinova, and let me also introduce my colleague Pavel Kocurek. We are both from the Czech Republic, namely from Tomas Bata University in Zlín, which is in the eastern part of our country, and particularly from the Faculty of Applied Informatics. First of all, we both would like to express our gratitude for the opportunity of being here today on the final Plastics conference here in the beautiful Slovin Gradec. Let me say a few words about the background or the history, how we could get here. It all started quite recently when the head of our research team, who is Professor Karel Kolomazník, was invited by Professor Miertuš and his long-term, very good colleague and friend, Professor Bakoš, to participate as the National Information Point and the member of the Global Network of Sustainable Plastics. Professor Kolomazník was very unhappy that he couldn't participate today, but me and my colleague we hope and we will do our best to act on his behalf, and we hope that our presence here today will be the beginning of a very fruitful and long-term cooperation between our faculty and with other top-ranking institutions who are dealing with bio-based plastics. Well, I will be quite short with the introduction, so let me now give word to my colleague Pavel, who will give a very brief overview about the situation of bioplastics in the Czech Republic, and I will finish with some practical examples that were done at our workplace.
So at the start, I ask, what does bioplastic mean in the case of Czech Republic? There exists no exactly definition of this term. Eco and bio are new trends and 21st century, and for the most of people it means to be closer to the nature or to do something more friendly for the environment or to have that feelings. So the bioplastics could, between the bioplastics could belong biodegradable materials based on the fossil resources and biodegradable polymers based on the biomass. In this case, it isn't necessary the biodegradability. But there is always the questions of ecobalance, because sometimes genetically modified plants are used, and the transport of raw material for long distances occurs. There is almost the questions of cost. Biodegradable plastics are more expensive than conventional plastics. We Czechs like environment, but we don't want to pay for it. We say something, but we do the other things. The problems with disposal could occur, because at the first sight, the products from biodegradable plastics is similar to products from conventional plastics. And at the end, there is a questions of lifetime, because we sometimes need the product with a short lifetime, and sometimes the product with long lifetime. So that's the questions of optimization of lifetime of the final product. So I have here some practical examples of raw materials for bioplastics production. Between the most used raw materials belong lactic acid, as we can see here. And the reaction proceeds this way. And the second one is the starch. Both raw materials were mentioned here in a last presentation, so it's well known. The research of bioplastics in the Czech Republic proceeds in some technical institution. One of them is Institute of Chemical Technology in Prague. Here I have the example, Department of Polymers, and this department is focused on the synthetic biodegradable polymers. You can see here some examples of biopolymers which are in research. The other institution is Tomas Bata University in Zlín, Center of Polymer Materials and the Center of Polymer Systems. In Zlín region, the plastic industry has a long tradition, so here is the research focused on composite materials and biodegradable polymers too. So the same university, but the other faculty. Here proceeds the research in the research group which is led by Professor Kolomazník. The research is particularly focused on edible food casings and the applications of protein hydrolysates from the processing of waste generated by tanning and the other industries. About this topic, we'll be speaking my colleague later. Here I have a few practical applications of bioplastics in Czech Republic. It's the examples of applications I have personally met or I heard about it. Few years ago, supermarkets gave plastic bags for free. And the result? One bag after one use equals waste. So now some supermarkets sell plastic bags for few crowns, and it's a good advertisement for the supermarkets, and the people do something friendly for the environment. Somebody says that these bags breathe, so it's good for the food storage. These writings means I'm the bio bag. The other applications is in the forest industry. You can see a tree container. It's used for the protection of tree against roe deer and ours. After the lifetime, it decomposes and it isn't necessary to remove it. Here in this picture, you can see my applications for plum trees protection. In Czech Republic are very popular some open air music festivals or some similar actions. But these actions are conducted with big production of plastics from food and beverages. So in year, I think, 2007, biodegradable dishes were used first times in this kind of festival. And the result, at the end of the festival, a hired company took all this waste with the rest of the food, and this waste was removed by composting. Sport shooting and hunting has a long tradition in Czech Republic and is very popular. And here in short gun cartridges we can find biopolymer too, because the wet, or if you want the plastic container, which is located between the pellets and the gunpowder, is sometimes made from degradable plastics. It's more environmental friendly for environment. In this case, you can see the cartridges for waterfowl hunting. So these cartridges contains steel pellets. So and UV degradable wet. So it's more friendly for the environment. And the other hand, the Czech law says that it's necessary to use in the case of waterfowl. That you can saw the only four examples of use. I think in the near future it will be more, but bioplastics aren't so enlarged in the Czech Republic. Now I give the word to my colleague, which will say you some more information about the research in Tomas Bata University.
So I would like to say a few words about some practical example of biodegradable polymers or, for example, the possible raw material for the production of biodegradable polymers that are directly related to our workplace. So this is Professor Karel Kolmazník. He is the head of the research team at our faculty. I will talk mainly about the first two points, but I would like to also mention the third one, because I am following the presentation of Professor Brownek from this morning, because we are dealing with biodiesel production from waste fats and oils. So it came to our mind just today that it could be somehow joined together, because biodiesel production is related with production of surplus of glycerin and also fatty acids. So we will contact very soon Professor Brownek. So, but the point of my presentation here today will be the first two points. Well, I think it would be quite different from what has been said today, because the majority of biodegradable plastics mentioned today were based on plant or the raw materials from the for the plant origin. We will be talking about collagen, which is a biopolymer, because Professor Kolmazník and our team have been had long tradition in the processing of leather waste. Well, the first example of biodegradable polymers are derived from the industrial processing of chrome-tainted shavings, which are the waste that is generated during leather production. Well, after some industrial process, which is depicted in this picture, we get protein hydrolysate. In every processing technology, we have to ask, are we able to find application for the products? So we were looking for the application of the protein hydrolysates. The first application on which Professor Kolmazník cooperated with the Eastern Regional Research Center of the US Department of Agriculture were biodegradable seed tapes used in agriculture to protect cultivated crops from thinning. There were two basic requirements for the biodegradable seed tapes. The first one was good mechanical properties, and at the same time they had to meet the soil condition for optimal seed sprouting. So what was tested? It was a mixture of polyvinyl alcohol with the addition of 20 to 40% of solid protein hydrolysate. The foils were produced by blow molding of the mixture of the polyvinyl alcohol and the hydrolysate. The results showed a considerable improvement in mechanical properties of the resulting material compared to pure polyvinyl alcohol. And the bonus was that it contained organic nitrogen, which was gradually released, so it at the same time it served as an organic fertilizer. You can find more in the publication, which is written here. If you are interested, just write an email to me. That will be context in the end of the presentation. I will send you the full paper. Other possible applications of protein hydrolysates are quite new. We are working on them now, and we have also submitted a Horizon 2020 project. The first area of application is the building industry. The protein hydrolysates can be used as an agent to join waste polystyrene dust with concrete mix. The new applications on which we are cooperating with the Faculty of Civil Engineering of Czech Technical University in Prague is utilization of protein hydrolysates in advanced admixtures, for example, in composite building materials based on cement, lime, or plaster, or gypsum. Other very promising application is testing of the effect of protein hydrolysates in elastomer mixtures in the rubber industry. Here we have two main cooperating institutions. One is the Faculty of Chemical and Food Technology from the Slovak Technical University in Bratislava, and the second, it is a company, it's VIPO, also from the Slovak Republic. Other possible application which we are now quite getting back to is the utilization of protein hydrolysates as sorbents, or if you rather say catchers, of free formaldehyde in furniture industry. The situation is that industrial adhesives are based on condensates of formaldehyde with, for example, urea, phenols, and etc. They have very good mechanical properties and are usually quite cheap. The disadvantage is that the polycondensation products contain a considerable share of free formaldehyde, which is considered carcinogen. So there is a continuous research for ingredients to reduce the content of free formaldehyde. One of our applications, we tested the solution of collagen hydrolysates added to urea formaldehyde resins in plywood production. The results were quite promising, but further research is needed. And especially it depends on the specific adhesive, because it was tested on the adhesive called Ducol, but it showed up that probably the composition of the adhesive may be one of the limiting factors of the utilization. And the third very important application are edible casings in the food industry that are based on collagen. We are cooperating with a company who is one of the leading producers of collagen-based edible casings of sausages. And the collagen casings are made from waste calcimine, which are limed collagen splits, also from the leather industry. The material is chemically treated and modified with cross-linking agents, plastifiers, and so on. There is an intensive research in cross-linking agents because it is very important to meet the very specific mechanical and thermal properties, because the casing on the sausage should should bear cooking and some other treatment. So we are now making research in the cross-linking agents, and at the same time, which is usually a problem, we are looking for some substances that meet the strict legislation on materials that are used in the food industry. And the last application I would like to talk about today is using collagen hydrolysates as biodegradable packing materials, because there are collagen hydrolysates that have such an origin that somehow restricts their application in pharmaceutical or food applications. And such hydrolysates can be made, for example, for the packing materials, for agricultural chemicals, and so on. In the publication, which is written at the very bottom of the slide, there is the description of testing the hydrolysates cross-linked with epichlorohydrin. This was done so far at laboratory scale, and I think that it would be necessary to discuss the economics of the whole process. So I would like to thank you very much for your kind attention. Here is the practical application of edible casings, and here you have all the contacts for our workplace. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.